It's estimated that up to 2 million Britons a year undergo some form of osteopathy. But even so, treatment is not available under the National Health, and the service is still frowned on by some sections of the medical establishment. Skepticism due in part to the fact that anyone can practice without qualifications. But here at the British School of Osteopathy, graduates spend 4 years training, and the school's own clinics include both physiotherapists and doctors, treating far more than the traditional sports and back injuries.
There's also an expectant mother's clinic, which is dealing with mothers through the various stages of pregnancy, as well as a children's clinic, which has been particularly interesting because they've had tremendous success with things like asthmatic children and bronchitic children.
With the Register of Osteopaths now showing 550 members, all of whom claim the majority of their patients are referred to them from within the NHS, royal patronage is clearly being regarded as the ultimate seal of approval.
Well, I think as a private institution, we're not a government-funded institution or a local authority-funded institution, it's very important to us to have some outside recognition of our status, and I think it will afford more reassurance to the general public that osteopathy is a respectable mode of treatment.
That said, Sir Norman was reluctant to explain exactly why Princess Anne should so honour the school, although he was willing to concede that many of their patients had sought treatment after painfully parting company with their horses. Stephen Chambers at the British School of Osteopathy for Thames News.
Is that all right?